Hi there. John Wilkinson here, History Made Easier. And in this short video, I want to talk about the decision makers during the July crisis that preceded World War I. There were only about 50 of them, and they were all men. An emperor, a kaiser, a czar, politicians, and military men. And they came from a small elite with a shared culture, shared values. Values like honor, loyalty, duty, a loyalty to your emperor, your czar, your kaiser, your country, a duty to your allies. For the politicians, there was also a sense that great power status depended on acting like a great power. For the military men, the values of order, discipline, self-sacrifice, obedience, and a sense that a country is only proven to be great in war. They weren't necessarily looking for war, but war would be their natural solution to a given problem. What was not considered was economic issues, territorial gain. They were not amongst the considerations of those making the decisions. Mobilization was. And here is where the military took over from the politicians, because the politicians couldn't argue against the military men's expertise. And the military considered mobilization as critical to winning a war. The war would be lost before it had begun, if the other side mobilized ahead of them. The Russians mobilized first because they knew it would take longer. It's a vast country and with a pretty poor railway network. The Germans knew that once they mobilized, it meant war. They couldn't turn back. Everything had been planned to work like clockwork. So the decision to mobilize was a big decision, and they knew what it meant. And so I think it's important to look at those decision makers. We still have to explain what got us to that point. But once we reach July, the decisions are taken away from the politicians and into the hands of the military. So I hope that was useful for you. And don't forget to check out my website. And if you find these videos interesting, please do subscribe to the channel. But anyway, thanks for listening. Cheers.